Hi, this is Tom Fastner with Teradata Labs, and I welcome you to Teradata TechBytes.
Teradata systems have always been configured with an eye on the data pipeline, from disk or SSD all the way to memory and CPU. Many features have been introduced, optimizing certain steps along the way. Various forms of compression, like multi-value compression, algorithmic compression, and block-level compression, mostly targeted the I/O bandwidth. FSG cache acts as the most recently used cache, keeping data from milliseconds to seconds. With more and more physical memory available in the node, there opened an opportunity for another caching structure. Teradata Intelligent Memory uses a most frequently used strategy, keeping data for minutes, hours, and maybe even days. The latest improvements focused on what's happening inside the CPU, specifically the processing and L1 caching. Intel chips support SIMD, single instruction, multiple data processing or vector processing. This allows you to apply the exact same instruction to multiple data at the same time in a single CPU step. Now that is pretty cool, but it leaves you with another challenge. How do you get the relevant data into the registers fast enough to be able to benefit from the concurrent execution? This is where the so-called cache-friendly structures come into play. If your data happens to be in columnar form in memory, the required data elements are already isolated and several of them will fit into level 1 cache at once and are ready to be processed, maximizing the performance gain. In Teradata 15.10, we are using those two techniques, SIMD processing and L1 caching in combination, to improve query performance. We implemented those in-memory optimizations for the following three operations. The first one is a new way of qualifying rows called bulk row qualification. The second is called in-memory hash join, which applies to both the classic as well as the dynamic hash join. And the third one is called in-memory optimized spool. A few things to consider. For the new in-memory optimizations feature to work, all AMP-related nodes need to have at least 512 GB of RAM. And the feature is targeted to a limited number of join types in Teradata 15.10. In future releases, the in-memory optimizations will expand to more join options. First, we are going to discuss the in-memory bulk row qualification. You see here a table called artist_album. Note that this table is either a columnar no PI or columnar PA table, which is required for bulk row qualification to be applied. So, I'm going to issue a query. Give me all the rows from the artist_album table where the producer is Smith. The column partition for producer is read and brought into memory. The SIMD, single instruction multiple data feature, will cause the qualification producer equals Smith to be loaded as the instruction for the vector CPUs and applied via the pointers in the vector list to the first set of data, at this time, most likely in level 1 cache. After the respective rows got qualified in parallel and written into the resulting spool, the pointers are pointed to the next set of data, and so on, until the data of the producer column partition has been processed. So it is not required that all data must fit into memory at once. In the explain plan, you will find the keywords bulk retrieve if bulk row qualification is being used. The next in-memory optimization has been implemented for the hash join. But first, let's look how the hash join has worked in the past. A hash join leverages memory and typically gets chosen by the optimizer when joining a small table with a very large table using an inner join. In this example, we have the small table on top with 6 rows and a large table on the bottom with 9 rows. Obviously, in real life, the numbers would be much bigger, but one requirement for using a hash join is the fact that the small table has to fit entirely in memory. In preparation for the hash join, the small table will be duplicated to all AMPs and kept in memory, and the large table is being read and all qualifying rows are written into a spool file. The join algorithm itself will go through the rows in the large spool file and for a row at a time will probe the small table, which sits in memory, for join partners. If there are join partners, the rows will be written out to another spool file. So now, what is different for the in-memory hash join? Both tables are spooled in preparation for the join. If the base table is a CP no PI or a CP PA, bulk qualification is used leveraging SIMD as discussed before, Otherwise, it is using the row-at-a-time qualification. This time, the data in spool is structured in a different way for both sides. It is no longer the full row. It is a subset of the columns organized in three columnar containers. The first container holds a primary index, the second container holds a column to be joined on, and the third container holds other data needed from the table to create the answer set. This structure is the in-memory optimized spool, and the hash join is its first implementation. The join will then be performed against those cache-friendly structures, optimizing the concurrency leveraging the SIMD feature. Please note that this feature is engaged when the optimizer thinks it's cheaper than the other join techniques, including the classical hash join, all based on the data demographics and the cost profile for a given configuration. And it works for row-based as well as column-based tables. You can verify if the optimizer chose this option by looking at the explain for R-joined using an in-memory hash join. The same optimization has been implemented for the dynamic hash join, which is yet another choice that the optimizer has for joining a small and a large table. In the classic dynamic hash join, all the rows from the small table are duplicated to all AMPs and placed in memory, as in the classic hash join example. For the large table, instead of writing rows into a spool, the row hash for the qualified rows is generated based on the joining columns, a row at a time across all AMPs. This row hash will be used to probe and join directly to the rows in memory, one row at a time. In the in-memory dynamic hash join scenario, the small table is duplicated in memory in a cache-friendly form, as in the in-memory hash join scenario. The main difference from the classic dynamic hash join is that the SIMD feature is used twice. During the preparation of the large table, the row hashes for multiple rows are generated at the same time instead of one row at a time, and the join will then be performed against those cache-friendly structures as in the in-memory hash join scenario.